Hi everyone, I am Karthikeyan Dandapani. In this video, we will see what it takes to build an Ansible playbook using AWS WLAN role. We will also execute the playbook and analyze the result. Let's get started by walking through multiple components of Ansible. We will need an inventory file, modules, and playbooks. To understand these components better, let's imagine a carpentry workshop. If Ansible modules are tools in your workshop, inventory of host are the raw materials, and the playbooks are the instruction manuals. In a nutshell, a playbook defines tasks to be performed on the inventory host using modules. First, let's install the AWS WLAN role. Execute the command ansible-galaxy install aruba networks dot AWS underscore WLAN underscore role. AWS WLAN role is now installed successfully. To know more about the AWS WLAN role, search for this role in the Ansible Galaxy page, and you can find more information in the README section. Let us create an inventory file. Inventory files are written in YAML format. We need to start by creating an all group and then add a host under the host section. Hosts are the target machines where the tasks are executed by Ansible playbooks. In this video, I am going to use two mobility conductors. Let's refer to the Ansible Galaxy role documentation to add variables to the mobility conductor. To prevent defining the common variables over and over, we can define them under the VAS section within the all group. If you have multiple mobility conductors distributed across various sites, a group per site can be created. Instead of defining host directly under all group, now there is a host section under each site group. Let us take this one step further by adding a group for the region and adding all sites in it. Now we can run the playbook against an individual host or an entire site or across the regions. We are all set for the inventory file. Now let us move on to the next section to create a playbook. A playbook contains an organized list of tasks which the user wants to execute on a particular host machine. Each playbook in Ansible consists of one or more plays. Within each play, there are three main sections. A host section can contain a single host or a group of hosts from the inventory file. Since we are using AWS WLAN role, we need to add this role in the role section. This role contains a connection plugin that can establish a HTTP API connection to the mobility conductor. This role also contains modules that will be leveraged in the next section. The AWS WLAN role comes with three types of modules. A generic configuration module can make any API call as supported by the Aruba mobility conductor. A show command module executes the show command in the Aruba mobility conductor and gets back the result. A configuration-specific module is designed for a specific use case. For example, AWS VLAN module can create, delete, or even update the VLAN ID in the mobility conductor. To get complete list of available modules, go to the AWS WLAN role documentation in the Ansible Galaxy and click on the GitHub repo button. You can find all the available modules in the library section. Each file name here represents a module name. To know more about these modules, you can execute ansible-doc command with a module name. Since these modules are part of the Ansible role, you can provide the path to the module using -m command. In this case, the roles are installed in the default Ansible role location. What we have here are the arguments that the module accepts and its description. There are also some example tasks built using these modules for reference. Let us create an Ansible playbook in the YAML format. Let's add hosts, roles, and tasks to our first play. US WISC group from the inventory file is used as hosts. For roles, let's add AWS WLAN Ansible role under the task section. Let's create first task. Let's create a Redis server profile by using generic configuration module AWS API config. I am going to copy the sample task provided in the module documentation. Let us keep the method as HTTP POST and config path is the configuration node hierarchy in the mobility conductor where this configuration will be effective. By setting commit to true a write memory operation will be performed, and this configuration will be pushed to the mobility conductor under the node hierarchy provided here. The data section contains the HTTP payload for the API request. Aruba Mobility Conductor supports multipart data. What it means for us is that we can provide data to multiple API endpoints in a single API request. Therefore, the data section accepts a list of API endpoints and its respective data. In this case, to create a RADIUS server profile, we have an endpoint named RAD server. This API endpoint accepts a RADIUS server profile name and a host IP address along with the other optional parameters. To know more about all the supported API endpoints and the data parameters it accepts, go to developer.arubanetworks.com and choose the AOS 8 page. Under the API references page, you will find all the supported API endpoints and its documentation. We have successfully created a playbook with a single task. Let's execute this playbook. The command to execute the Ansible playbook from the terminal is ansible-playbook and then the playbook name with -i inventory file name. We can see that the task named create a RADIUS server is executed on the host MMA and MMB defined under the US West group in the inventory file. Change flag in the Ansible playbook summary result shows that the configuration is changed in the Aruba Mobility Conductor. Let us verify the partial config changes in the Aruba Mobility Conductor. We can see that the configuration was successful. Let us now add another task to add newly created RADIUS server profile to a RADIUS server group. To do this, I am going to go back to the API references page and check the API endpoint name. The name for the API endpoint can be found here, and the required body parameters are server group name and auth server. Within the auth server section, let's add the previously defined RADIUS server profile name. We are done with adding the second task in our playbook. Let's execute this. Both the tasks have run successfully. Upon completion of the playbook, we can see that the change flag is set only for one of the tasks because the first task to create a RADIUS server profile was run previously. The Ansible module we used did not reconfigure the same task in the mobility conductor. This feature of Ansible is called idempotency. We can see from the mobility conductor that both the RADIUS server profile and the server group has been created. Alright, this is everything for this video. Thank you everyone for watching.